for people who haven't seen it, can you tell us a little bit about the story? What made you so determined to be a part of it?
Well, the movie starts with my son's 5th birthday, and you see me as sort of a young, worn-down mother. And as you look at our surroundings and where we're living, it looks like a very sparse, small apartment, perhaps, and we have very little resources. But as the story unfolds, you realize that as a young girl, I was kidnapped, and I've been held captive in this room for 7 years. And that's the setup for and the fuel for the two of us to work together to create an escape plan. And then the majority of the movie is us out in the world learning about how things are now. I didn't find it all that challenging. I actually found it to be a very safe, beautiful space. I imagine it's similar to if you were doing a play, and that feeling of the separation between reality and when you step on stage was the same thing with Room, where although in the film it's a locked door, in reality it wasn't. And so Room became this sort of doorway that we could pass through, and then it became this very intimate space that Jacob and I could work together in.
What's amazing about the novel is that it's, you think it's going to be one sort of thing, and it's very, very much something else. So, for example, it's set in the first half is set in a single room. It's about a woman and her son, and the woman has been kidnapped 7 years before, and she's had a child with the kidnapper, and she is raising this child in a very small space. And what's incredible about it is she's managing to do a pretty amazing job. So she's created a childhood for this boy. She's protected him from the darker sides of what's happening. And we enter the story when they've been there for 5 years together, and they're in this routine, and they're reaching a point where she realizes this can't be sustained, and we're going to have to get him out. We're going to have to get ourselves out of here. So it's an escape story, really, and it's a story about journeying back to life from something for her, for the mother, and it's a story for the boy of coming to terms with the large amazingness of the world, having grown up in this tiny little box. I was actually talking about Room before I made Frank, and because it took quite a long time from when I read the novel to getting sort of into dialogue with Emma, and then, you know, actually I made a movie called What Richard Did around the same time as I started thinking about Room, and that movie did quite well and made a bit of a splash at Toronto, and all of those things helped in getting me to the position where I could get the rights to make the film I wanted to make. And then I was in pre-production, I think, or beginning to get near pre-production on Frank while I was working very intensively with Emma. So it was two incredibly different projects going through my head at the same time. The madness and kind of freewheeling craziness of Frank, and then this much more concentrated, emotionally sincere film in Room. I mean, I think every time you shoot, it's like exercise. You just, you know, it helps me develop. And I think Frank was a tough, hard shoot. And I think it was good. I felt like battle hardened enough after Frank to go into something as demanding as Room. Well, Emma, because she was so intimately involved in it and also sat in some of the shooting, she'd come and visit. She did know where we were going with it, but then she saw it, a nearly finished cut in New York a few months ago. She cried, and she hugged me, and she was really happy, and that meant a tremendous amount to me. And then in terms of the fans of the book, I think generally speaking, it's been really, really positive. People have said that they felt it was a sort of truthful, you know, internally truthful, true to the spirit and the emotional resonance of the book. And that's important as well, because it's a great book, and I didn't want to have its fans feel that we had taken it and done anything bad with it. Now, I have worked with children before, but, you know, a child to carry a film to the extent that he carries this film is an incredibly hard ask, as they say. So until we really got into it, I didn't know. I knew that he had it in him artistically, but would he have the stamina? How would he feel? Would he get embarrassed? Would he have days where he just didn't want to come out and work? And you can't force a small child to do something they don't want to do. So I had many sleepless nights before we shot, and it was probably about 4 or 5 days into what was a 50-day shoot, so quite a long shoot. I started to relax. I was looking at the rushes. I could feel the relationship between the two protagonists. I could feel how solid Jake is, you know, 7-year-old boy, but like, he just came out every day dying to do it, you know, enthusiastic, clever, you know, I just struck gold. I never worked as closely with anybody as I did with Brie, really, because I started talking to Brie months and months and months before we started filming, and we really developed that character along with Emma Donoghue, the character of Ma. And then we were all amazed when we found Jake Tremblay, who is this fantastic, brilliant young actor who was 7 when we started, turned 8, and who really has to carry the film on his shoulders. And what was, I think, a sensible thing to do is we got Brie and Jake together for 3 to 4 weeks before we started filming. And that gave them an opportunity in just really relaxed way to bond, get to know each other and kind of become friends. And I think that's what you see on screen. You feel the quality of their relationship.